Fabio Perini is one of our relevant customers that started to use LeanCOST 2 years ago by performing important results. And today it's a pleasure for me to introduce Mr. Marco Salvini, costing manager at Fabio Perini. And so Marco, let's talk about your experience with LeanCOST.
Okay, so first of all, thank you to be invited to this kind of meeting. This seminar is very important for us because it is giving us the opportunity to show what we did and how Fabio Perini is strictly involved in increasing their technology. Fabio Perini is an Italian leader company in design and manufacturing of industrial machinery for tissue paper and for converting. It was founded in 1966, and now Fabio Perini is part of a big group, a German group called Korberg. Fabio Perini is a worldwide company which has a headquarters in Italy, in Lucca, and six different plants over the world. So it is important for us to be completely structured, and we have to follow very defined and clear guideline in development. Everything that we have to do is in line with the procedure which has to be approved by our German house. Fabio Perini, as I told you before, is part of a multinational company and has a very important R&D department, and which has several patents on converting, embossing, paper machining, and so on. Our products are, as you could see from the pictures, starting from small line with 10 meters length up to big converting lines which are 100 meters in length. And we are producing, starting from the paper roll, we are able to produce toilet paper roll or kitchen paper roll and packet everything inside. So in order to do that, we have to, in order to stay in the market, we have every time to fight with the competitors, and it means that even if we are high technology provider and high performances provider, we have very important eyes on the cost. To be on the leader means for us to give to our customers very good product, and in the same times we are being able to give it to a fair value price. So it means that for Fabio Perini, costing is really, really one of the two drivers to sell machine. One is performance and the other one is cost. If I am able to produce a very good machine, but I cannot sell it, I can do it through in the basket. So it is clear that for us, we have to define since the beginning how much does our machine cost. And it is done by a clear defined bill of material with a clear defined process, and everything has to be defined into the development phase. We are not a company which can count the cost at the end of the process, but we have to define the cost at the beginning of the developing of our line. And because of that, we have to find out something which is close to our market. So what we define internally is a procedure called feed-forward costing. This is something like a step-and-gate process in where since the beginning we have to define material cost, a bill of material, effort in terms of labor cost, and so on. And because of that we have a process called internal estigate, which force the development, the engineering team to produce and bomb for the bill of material of the machine since the beginning. Each kind of components inside the bill of material has to be costified by a team, And such kind of components has to be investigated by the purchasing organization in order to find out the cheapest and the best company to be supplied, in order to have the possibility to stay on the target cost that the organization put inside. Fabio Perini, as I told you before, Fabio Perini has such kind of knowledge since several years. In 2000, it was generated the first costing team inside the company. And starting from Excel files, starting from in-house process development, we were able to define in such way. Here you can see clearly there is product costing by our internal ERP starting from the two drawings, and we have the possibility internally to define single cost of components. But it this is something that we did at the end of the process of the drawing. We had the possibility to map the Hyperlean, and we had the possibility to discover the possibility to use the 3D cost estimation system. With the 3D cost estimation system, we were able to process the drawings starting from the 3D CAD and process it and generate the cost. In order to do such kind of processing, we had to start a pilot project. The pilot project means that we had some license, in that case two full license, and we had a specific period of training plus a specific period of tuning. In different words, we have our internal cost estimation system, and we wanted to verify that Link were able to give us the same information in terms of cost of the components we were costifying. So, because of that, we tested 100 different configuration of drawing parts, and we tuned our system in order to find out a clear cost for that. Then we compare it with the purchasing, and we find out a quotation from the customers, from the supplier, in order to have information to fill in and to increase the database that we use for that. At the end of the story, we did a go live on the process. Now we are having four different licenses completely running in Fabio Perini, and from the starting from the drawings, from the 3D drawings, we can clearly put and have an estimation for our costing for our purchasing organization to buy the components. But we have a clear information also for the R&D in order to define good developed solution for being cost. In different words, the 3D cost estimation that we are doing with LeanCOST, we are able to put our system in the position to really do what we call it design for costing, because we are able to change the drawings inside of the system and verify the impact of such kind of modification directly in terms of cost. As the moreover, we were able to export such kind of results in our ERP system, and we are using information coming from the costification of link cost of drawing parts as standard cost in our ERP. So we are giving the target to our purchasing organization to buy parts according to this kind of information. So from our point of view, what we could say is that the having a 3D models in a company which are using 3D drawings is a very important thing, because it is in one way give the costing team faster in cost prediction, because it is easier for us to define cost and so on. In the other way, it is such kind of information are completely free into the ERP, and all the organizations, starting from the purchasing up to the development guys, can have information on the cost effect of their drawing and on the cost effect of their buying. Now, what I will show you is a short movie on a typical case. As you could say, here you can see staffa movimentazione is a part of our components, is a welded part. This is an assembled part welded. So you can see in the movie how easy it is to use it. As a first things, the system is able to recognize the geometry. And it is extracting geometry again. And as you could see, it is able by their own, if the information are into the PMI parts of the 3D software, it is able to predict, information on threads, roughness, tolerances, and everything which is included into the 3D drawings, the system is able to define. If it is not, you can every time adapt such kind of information and using the 3D step file as a source of information. But if your system is integrated, as in our case in NX, you can search all the information directly from your PMI into the system. As you could see here, it is able to recognize surface, thickness, and you can also fix the roughness as you prefer. There are color scale which are able to generate the information. Here, what you can see is how we are giving the information of the material, and then we define the strategy of costing. So it means that in this case, you can also post-process your 3D drawings with different material to see if the costs are cheaper or higher with a different material and with different configuration of the drawings. Here, when you say the logic, as you could see, once again, this is a Fabio Perini, because this is our internal logic. For each component you are evaluating, you have to define a specific logic if you want to use something which is not standard, or you can use the standard part. In Fabio Perini, we use the standard part, and we customize it in some cases. But here, as you could see, once that you define the structure, here it is selecting, as you could see, different pieces. The system is able to recognize it. And from the raw material, you can define everything which has to be removed by the turning part, and also all the other machining actions that here we can do. And at the end of the story, based with the 3D information and with the information of process that we are using, and basing also on the cost of the machine, we can evaluate a clear information in terms of cost. Here, you can every time change, and you can select different options if you want to say different cutouts, different hole diameter, and so on. You can change it also during the running in order to be flexible in understanding the impact of potential modification. And the system is able also in recognizing the welding side. And as you could see here, it is once again recognizing weldments and also the machining parts that operation that you have to do before and after the before and after the costing. As you could see here, the system defines a specific cost based on component cost, setup cost, and so on. Each kind of this information are part of the cost of the activity-based costing inside of the tool, which are able to predict the cost. And if you have a specific target in your components, you can, as you could see here, set up a target cost and run it, and the system will inform you in case of cost, and also you can try to find out which is the best best batch quantity in order to reach your target. You know, this is an important information when you are doing batches as a machine, in order to understand which is the economical best performer value that you have to ask to your supplier. And once again, all these data are tuned with the reality of Fabio Perini supplier and with the reality of our system. At the end, you can have also a report, as you can see here, which give you all the information for each, for the complete assembled part and for the single components that you have inside. And you can have also the results in terms of, as you could see, cost and so on. Moreover, at the end of the story, everything can be exported. At the beginning, we exported it in an Excel file, as you could see here. Later, we find out the system, and we let the system exporting this kind of information directly in our ERP. So now all the information are inside our system. So at the end of the story, the cost evaluated by the LeanCOST is completely stored in my ERP system to define the standard cost or reference cost for the purchasing. This is a pilot project timeline, which is showing you the efforts that we did. As you could see, we started in September 2015 with the system installation and so on. We did a training, running a tuning model and testing phase. It was done by a tester in my team. This is a very good engineer which knows purchasing, which is very expert in define the tuning, and also is an expert in machining, so he could be the real perfect tester that I have. Then we define and implement the transaction to transfer LeanCOST in our ERP, as I told you before. Then as we define it, we run and we verify the process with the, as you could see, phase E with R&D and viewers. Viewers are the module that we in Fabio Perini installed for our purchasing, which can every time see the standard cost that we saved plus all the operation, all the manufacturing steps in order to define the production cycle with the supplier and see and so in some way to define something like a negotiation. And at the end of the story, we define and close all the weakness that we have, and we have launched as a go live in Fabio Perini this LeanCOST since June 2016. As per your information, because of the good results from such kind of system in Fabio Perini, the Corbe Group, which is the holding which is Fabio Perini is part of, copy and paste our LeanCOST tool inside two other different companies, which are one in medical and one in grinding machine area.